Hi, I'm Mr. E-Tutor, your mystery tutor here at mysterytutor.com, and welcome to video module 4-6. In this module, we're going to take some of the lessons that we learned in attacking the reading comprehension questions on the SAT and apply them to the rest of the test. Remember, understanding the reading comprehension process and taking something that seems so intimidating to most students and so subjective and turning it into something mechanical and repetitive is the key to understanding every other question type on the test. Once you can answer reading comprehension questions, you should have no problem at all with the other questions. And as we've seen, it's not that hard to learn how to approach the reading comprehension section. One of the most important lessons to take away from this series is the fact that the College Board has to design every single question so that it's completely bulletproof and completely beyond argumentation. If they didn't do that, as we've discussed many times, the SAT would have no value for colleges because it wouldn't provide reliable data. And if it didn't provide reliable data, colleges would stop telling you to take it, and the College Board would no longer exist. So the College Board does everything it can to maintain the integrity and consistency of its SAT question. This is only one more reason that you have to practice with this book and not with any other source of SAT question. The only real SAT questions that follow all the standards we've talked about and all the standards we're going to talk about appear in this book by the College Board. Don't use any other source. The most important thing to take away from these questions is the idea that one or two words alone can make the difference between a totally correct answer choice and a totally incorrect answer choice. You're going to see this over and over again all throughout the test. It's the case with sentence completion questions. It's the case with all kinds of math questions. It's the case everywhere. To do well on the SAT, you have to learn to read word by word, take in every single word, and think very carefully about what it means. Remember, this is a skill that really doesn't get rewarded at all in high school. In high school, it's totally fine to get the broad strokes right, but not get the details exactly right. On the SAT, it's all about the details. Every single aspect of the test is standardized, remember that, and the standards depend on every single word. So, thanks for watching these modules. I hope you now understand how easy it is to approach the reading comprehension questions. And remember, the rest of the test is easier than you think too.